Well, thank you everyone for checking out my Wicked Game video. My name is Damian Bacci and welcome to my back room here in sunny Tampa Bay, Florida. Wicked Game is a really great tune, so let's talk a little bit about it. Now, this very dreamy and haunting tune is in the key of B minor, and the song is from Chris's third studio album, Heart-Shaped World, which was released in 1989. Now, Wicked Game didn't become a hit until it was featured in David Lynch's 1990 film, Wild at Heart. But by the end of 1991, the song had become a worldwide hit. Now, the song's vocals have a very Roy Orbison-esque feel to it. The ballad is very similar to Roy's Only the Lonely and Crying. Chris's Wicked Game definitely fits into that style of song. But besides being a great song and Chris's great vocals, we've got one of the coolest sounding and beautiful guitar lines and tones ever to be played on a song. And the man responsible for all that was James Calvin Wilsey, also known as the King of Slow. Now, Wilsey played on Chris Isaak's first four studio albums, and I think it's safe to say that Chris Isaak's success and the success of the song Wicked Game is equally due to the talents of Isaak and Wilsey. And there's no doubt in my mind, if James hadn't played guitar on Wicked Game, it wouldn't have been the hit that it became. The success of Chris Isaak and Wicked Game was fueled from both of them. And actually, Chris Isaak was not a solo act at first. James and Chris were in a band together called Silvertone. And when they released their first album, they couldn't use that name because Sears had already trademarked that name for their electronics and musical instruments. So their debut album went under the name Chris Isaak, and the title of the album was called Silvertone. Now let's get to the good stuff. Let's talk about James playing on Wicked Game. Now Wilsey was a Fender Stratman. He played a Stratocaster on the song, and it's said that he played through his 1964 Fender Deluxe amp. And of course, I'm hearing generous amounts of reverb, some delay, and possibly some gentle vibrato. Now the lines that he chose to play and the tone of the guitar is so atmospheric, soothing and tranquil. It's just so dreamy. And it sounds like to me that he was probably a fan of the shadows. Because when I listen to this song, I get some major Hank Marvin vibes. Now the notes that James plays in this song is exactly what the tune needed. He doesn't overplay, he doesn't show off. He simply plays those subtle, mysterious passages, giving us layers of dreamy sonic landscapes. And if you will, I simply call it absolutely brilliant playing. Now sadly, James died in 2018, but he left us some beautiful guitar playing to listen to and enjoy whenever we'd like. And even though Wicked Game came out over 30 years ago, people are still listening to it, playing the song, learning how to play it. It's a timeless piece of music that will forever be enjoyed. Now friends, if you enjoyed this video today, please give it a thumbs up. It really helps me out. And if you haven't already, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. This will keep you up to date on all my newest guitar lessons. And also on my website, I have some great full-length courses on rockabilly guitar and on jump blues guitar. They're available as downloads or as DVDs. You can purchase them at DamianBacci.com. And friends, these courses will not disappoint. Now friends, before I go, I'd like to leave you with some inspiring words. And I'd like to talk to you about dealing with emotional and physical pain. This is something that every human being goes through at one time or another. Now I've definitely had my share of emotional pain and physical pain. And for the past year, I've been dealing with a lot of physical issues. But you're probably saying to yourself, well Damian, I certainly haven't noticed. And that's simply because I have a choice. Now I certainly can't control what life throws at me. But I won't let it stop me, and I won't let it break me. I look at suffering as a choice. Now, I'm not saying that I'm not hurting or that I don't feel pain. It's just that I'm not going to let my adversity get me down. You know, life doesn't always lead you to where you want to go, and that's okay. And if you're resilient, then you'll know that only you has the power and the responsibility to lift yourself up. And with that, friends, I'm going to say goodbye to you. Much love to everybody out there. Stay safe, and I'll see you in another guitar lesson real soon. Take care. Bye-bye.